Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we have to discuss different principles, techniques and practices of the quality management. Therefore, first of all, I would like to share with you the principles of quality management. You know, this is the class of PhD education with the course Quality Management in Education. And here is Dr. Ijaz Ahmed Tatla with you as a resource person for this course. So we come about towards the principles of quality management. While discussing about the principles of quality management, the first principle is customer focus. You can see here, organizations depend on their customers and therefore should understand current and future customer needs, should meet customer requirements and strive to exceed customer expectations. Further, you can see in this diagram, how respectfully and decently they are welcoming the customer. The salesman have a bunch of flowers with him, and very pleasingly he has warm welcomed his customer and presenting him the flower or the item. And the title given here in this diagram is "I accept, but there may be some monitoring for quality assurance." Okay, all the pleas of customer, because the product, if the product is market driven, acceptable in both of sense, in terms of its cost and utilization, and its acceptance at large in the market, are the indicators of customer acceptance. So on the basis of this, the companies and the organizations have to focus towards the customer. Whether their product is meeting the needs of the customer or not, on the basis of this principle, they can earn much more benefits. Principle two is the leadership. Leaders establish unity of purpose and direction of the organization. They should create and maintain the internal environment in which people can become fully involved in achieving the organization's objective. As here it is stated that the leader's role is to establish unity of purpose and direction. So for common purpose, they have to push their followers and they have to direct them to go for the achievement of that purpose for the organization. So they create environment that is conducive towards the full involvement of the workers of the organization towards the achievement of the set goals. Third principle is involvement of people. No doubt, while managing quality, it's very necessary. People at all levels are the essence of an organization, and their full involvement enables their abilities to be used for the organization's benefit. So the involvement of workers of the organization from bottom to top in all type of decision making give them pleasure and they feel ownership, and they put their potential into practice to achieve the target goals, and this finally yields good fruits for the organization. Process approach is another principle of the quality management. According to this, a desired result is achieved more efficiently when activities and related resources are managed as a process. No doubt, a systematic approach and a certain process, step by step performed activities, plays vital role towards the achievement of desired goals. So to meet these goals, process approach is necessarily adopted in the quality management. Principle 5, system approach to management. Herein, identifying, understanding, and managing interrelated processes as a system contributes to the organization's effectiveness and efficiency in achieving its objectives. The total focus of quality management, no doubt, is towards the achievement of its set goals. Therefore, they identify the different understandings and manage them and correlate them with the prevailing processes through which organizational effectiveness and efficiency is enhanced, and resultantly the targets are achieved. One more principle of quality management is continual improvement. You know, continual improvement of the organization's overall performance should be a permanent objective of the organization. Why? Because quality is not bounded. It's an ongoing process. It's a lifelong process without which the products cannot be uniformed and in total cannot be of good quality. So it's a permanent process, permanent objective. The overall good performance of the organization is permanent objective because the product of meet the needs of the customer and the society and novelty and currency in the field is the permanent objective of the organization. So to meet that, they have to go through all the time, all the ways through continual improvement. They cannot stop at any certain stage that they have achieved the benchmark, so it's fine enough now, because with the change of time, environment, culture, and the societal needs, for any of the organization, it is necessary to go through continuous improvement. Another principle for quality management is factual approach to decision making. An effective decision is based on the analysis of data and information. So the information collected from the different components is analyzed, and on the basis of that information, that data, effective decisions are made. So to make certain decisions, facts are very necessary to be identified. Without factual data, right decisions are unable to be made. Another principle and the last principle of quality management stated here is that mutual beneficial supplier relationship. No doubt, to maintain quality, it's very necessary. Supplier and consumer mutual relationship is very necessary to be established, because an organization and its suppliers are interdependent, and a mutual beneficial relationship enhances the ability to both to create value, because supplier and the producer should be on the same page, and they have to take care of the benefits of each other. So by looking into the mutual benefits, the production and quality both is managed, enhanced, and it adds in value. So towards value addition, it's very necessary. The organization and supplier should be looking after the beneficial mutual benefits. In next video, you will see and watch the practices of quality management.